Hello everyone, thanks for tuning into today's second video, doing Jeremy Friday for today's second video. So as always on a Friday, we're having a look at the weather for the month ahead with the Japanese and the CFSB 2 models. Having said that, I haven't done it for the last couple of weeks. It's actually the first one for 3 weeks since he's been in hospital with a fractured ankle. But anyway, we're back today. So we're going to have a look at the weather for the month ahead with Japanese and CFSB 2 models. Going to take us well into July. And I shall get on with that for you in a moment, just to say that the first video today was our 6th UK weather forecast. Got 10 to 14 there, and the first Glasgow update of the season will be coming up this evening as well. Please like, share, and subscribe on all of today's bits of content. And thank you so much, everybody, for doing that for Gav's weather this. Thank you so much, everyone. Right, going to start off with week one, 500 millibar high tsunami from the JMA, from the Arctic and the North Pole view down. So this is the North Pole just here. Got the wider Arctic Circle around there, and they've got middle latitudes through here. So blue is blue is extrapolated to below average heights, which is low pressure. Yellow, orange, and red to above average heights, which is high pressure. These are broken down into weekly periods. The first week period will take us from the 14th to the 21st of June. So the next week, we'll have high pressure in the Atlantic, ridging from the Atlantic up towards Greenland, with a trough of low pressure centered right over top of UK and Ireland. The jet stream will be down here somewhere. So an unsettled and rather cool week to come there. Week two will be the 21st, 28th of June. High pressure takes over towards Scandinavia. That should turn the wind into the east and should be a lot drier. And you would have thought rather warmer as well, actually. And then weeks three and four will take us from the 28th of June to the 13th of July, with a ridge of high pressure, resource high down to the southwest, probably bringing in some sort of a west or westerly, or maybe slightly northwesterly flow. Should bring a lot of dry weather to the south, but it could be a little bit mixed, so up in the north. Remember, it's a two-weekly anomaly, though, so it could be transitional. So it could be something like week three, still dominated by high pressure, but more to the southwest, and then week four is more unsettled. Something like that could be going on there. Right, so this is the tropical and the mid-latitude view. We can't see the Arctic, Greenland, Iceland, Scandinavia, all those areas off the chart up here. But UK and Ireland, top right-hand corner of the chart, as you're looking at it, reminder of the week one, 500 millibar height anomaly with a trough of low pressure centred over top of UK and Ireland, combined with a ridge in the Atlantic, sending the jet stream down here. So looking rather cool and unsettled in the weekend. But temperature anomaly is below average for the week to come. So another cool week in what has been really quite a chilly June. And also rather on the wet side as well. Not surprising given a trough of low pressure parked over the country. So a cool wet week to come for the third week of June. Into week four, the last week of June, it's all change. It takes us from the 23rd, 28th of June. High pressure takes over to the east and also to the northeast. You can visit Scandinavia, will be up here somewhere. Should turn the wind into more of an easterly. So the temperature anomaly is slightly above average, becoming rather warmer there for the last week of June. And it's also drying out as well, with a lot of the rain being pushed off away to the northwest. And then weeks three and four will take us from the 28th of June to the 13th of July. Some higher pressure just to the southwest, and winds coming in from a generally westerly direction. The temperature anomaly is slightly above average, though not a particularly big deviation. Precipitation anomalies are turning wetter up into the north, but are rather drier down in the south. Okay, let's see how the CFS compares then. So again, these are 500 millibar high tsunami, breaking down to week periods. The first week period takes us from the 14th to the 20th of June, meaning next week we'll have low pressure through the north and the west of Europe. It is in combination with high pressure in the North Atlantic, so certainly a more unsettled week to come there. That's high pressure. Certainly an unsettled week to come there for the first week of June. Now, it stays unsettled into week two as well. This is the 21st, 27th of July. So this is when the JMA is building that ridge over to the East Country. The CFS does have that as well, but it's a little bit further away with the ridge, and we keep more of an Atlantic influence, actually. So Probably warmer, yes, with the wind going to more of a southerly southwesterly, but I think that will still be rather unsettled, actually. However, we do get there eventually, so week three will be the 28th of June to the 4th of July, general election day, with high pressure taking over across Scandinavia and pulling wind into the east. That should be a very warm, maybe quite a hot start to July. And look at this, week four is the 5th to the 11th of July, with high pressure centred over the top of the UK and Ireland. That should be another mostly warm and potentially very dry, dare I even say it, rather hot week there for that week, the 5th to the 11th. So after, well, I think most people would classify as quite a disappointing year. I know some people do like it cooler and wetter in the summer, but I think most people classify this as rather disappointing June. We could be seeing big improvements here into July, if that's right. Well, anyway, it's a long way off though, week three and four. Let's have a look at the temperature anomaly. Week one, cooler than average, significantly below average, actually. And there is a bit of a lift up in the upper air temperature, I should say, week two, 21st to the 27th. Of June, but not by much. It's only ever so slightly above average, near normal to a little bit above. However, week three does start to warm things up, so going into the orange colours then. And by the time we get through to week four, which is the 5th to the 11th of July, then we see temperature anomaly is 1 to 2 Celsius above normal, very warm potentially. And finally, the precipitation anomaly for the 14th to 20th of June looks like that. So a wetter than average week to come generally. Week 2, 21st, 27th of June is also wetter than normal. Week 3 will be the 28th of June to 4th of July. That a little bit drier than average, and it stays drier into week 4 as well, 5th to 11th of June. That also coming out drier than normal. Okay, so it looks like we've got further mixed weather to come for June, certainly for next week. We might see a bit of an improvement into the last week of the month, but when we get into July, there are one or two hints here that we might see much more in the way of high pressure. If we do, then summer will be game on for summer. Maybe just a snapshot of what the two models are showing, so we could look completely different when we look at them again next week, and we may try and do the HMWF 42 day forecast for you tomorrow. I might leave that off for one more week. I'll see if I can get it in tomorrow. It would be nice to have a look at that, wouldn't it? I'll see if I can get it in for tomorrow. Just gradually, you know, increasing the content and getting things back. Right, okay, so that's Jeremy Friday done. First time in 3 weeks, got 10 to 14 there, and then the first Glasto update will be released this evening. If you enjoyed the video, please like, share, and subscribe, and we'll be back with more very soon. For this one, though, that's all for now, and thanks for watching.